This is Lady Boulay, and I hope you're having a wonderful day. Thank you for your support. Thank you for subscribing to the channel. Thank you for your thumbs up, for your comments, and thank you for sharing the videos. Thank you for all you do to support the channel. And yes, we are commanded to love one another, whether we want to or not, or whether we agree with each other or not. I have to repeat, when I started this channel, I had 3 subscribers, and then I had 12 subscribers. These were people of my lineage. So I started this channel saying that it was exploring African-American culture and history. So when I say we're commanded to love each other, I was really talking about people in my lineage. I wasn't talking about the whole world. I'm supposed to love you and you don't love me. So you know they say charity, which is love, begins at home and spreads abroad. So you first start loving at home and then you spread that love abroad. That is what I am attempting to do on this channel. I want my people to love each other enough for us to start solving our problems. And when other people get in the mix, it's because they have attacked our lineage in some way. And so my channel is about providing information to the lineage of Black American people. So when people come in here referencing the fact that I said we are commanded to love each other, if you are not of that lineage, don't assume that that message is for you. You're not commanded to love me if you're not of my lineage. But if you're of my lineage, you really are. And you should be asking yourself why you don't love your people if you don't. Furthermore, the African descended family, and that's all African people, are under global attack. If we don't see it in Africa, if we don't see it in Brazil, if we don't see it in the Caribbean, if we don't see it in America, then we can't see. So all I'm doing on this channel is saying that Black Americans, if nobody else is going to love us, we ought to love each other. Now that's what I'm saying to people of my lineage. Now as far as the diaspora is concerned, there is so much misinformation. There are so many lies that have been told about everybody that we really don't even know where to start with each other. If we got a different look than somebody else, all of that has been weaponized against us. So we actually have to start from scratch if we're going to ever get along, because the reality is we can deny it all we want to. All of us are in the same matrix. The same thing that's happening here is happening in the Caribbean, down there in Haiti. Half of us, and I'm trying to figure out what's going on down there. You can't even figure it out because some people say this barbecue person is a thug. And then some people say he's trying to liberate Haiti. Kenya has a force down there, a police force down there trying to restore order. Now they say Jamaica has sent a force down there trying to restore order. So we don't know which way to turn because who's pulling the strings? So I'm just saying, for me, I can't solve the world's problem, but I know a little bit about what's going on here in America. And we need to solve our own problems in America, beginning with loving ourselves, loving each other, and building our self-esteem. Now, there's a talk recently about Black Americans gatekeeping our culture, which is what we really need to do. But this has caused some confusion in this so-called Black diaspora. And I think that it would be instructive to listen to what this young lady has to say about that.
People of the Black diaspora, let's talk, please. So right now, I'm seeing a lot of infighting within the diaspora because we tend to do this at least once a month. This time, it's about gatekeeping an ancestral language for Black Americans, those of us who descend from enslaved Africans in the United States. Some people who are Black are upset by this, but I challenge you to think about this. If you have the ability to know more than one language, you are privileged. If you have the ability to know the language of your ancestors, you are privileged. African Americans, for the most part, do not have this privilege. But getting to the gatekeeping part, I want some of you all to understand this. When Black Americans do something, it is either stolen and appropriate it, or there is a law passed against it, or a law has to be passed to stop the discrimination. Let's take 2021. Critical race theory has been banned in a lot of schools where it's not even taught. What is actually banned? The teaching of Black American history in the school system. Because there has been a desire amongst Black Americans to learn their history. So a law was passed to prevent this. Similar to when Black people in America who were enslaved tried to learn to read, but laws were passed to prevent us from learning to read and write. When it comes to the way that our hair grows out of our scalp, there is a law called the Crown Act that is being put in place that we are fighting for to ensure that we do not get discriminated against because of the way that our hair is textured in the workplace or in schools. We have to pass another law to try to prevent discrimination. Previously, there was the Tillon laws that discriminated against us for our hair texture. Voting. So many African Americans voted last year that now there are literal laws being passed to prevent us from voting in numbers again. And it is being blocked in Congress. So when it comes to us learning Tutanese, I need the diaspora to understand something. For the most part, a law will be passed or it will be stolen from us. I just need y'all to understand that that is how it works in the United States. So when it comes to us gatekeeping this, it is to protect us from having it stolen or a law passed so that we cannot learn it. We have seen historically that consequences can happen when Black Americans try to have access to anything dealing with our culture in the United States of America. So before you make a video being in your feelings, please consider that. Please do.
She nailed it. I don't think I could improve on that. We gatekeep our culture to keep it from being hidden and to keep it from being stolen or to keep a law being passed against it. And that's the story of Black Americans and why we are trying to gatekeep our culture. And right now, it doesn't have anything to do with anybody else in the Black diaspora. It has to do with us here in America. Okay, y'all, thank you for listening. Let me know what you think about the video and have a good evening.